Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. The first thing I'd like to say here is that I was way too excited when I made those first five parts, even to the point that I misspoke a couple of times. Like, in Bianco Hills, when I did the second shine, I kept saying that I was gonna go up to the lighthouse, when in fact there is no lighthouse whatsoever. It's actually a windmill village. But if little mistakes like that hinder the experience and ruin the video for you completely, well, you're an idiot. But I just wanted to get that disclaimer done and over with. Oh, and if you didn't notice, the more shines that you get, the more light appears on the Delfino Plaza here. Evidently, the sun up there just isn't bright enough to light this area. It needs the shine sprites or something like that. Yeah, I don't get it either. As you can see, there's a transition between the shine sprite lit area here and the very dark area here. Well, it's not very dark, it's still visible, but you get what I mean. Anyway, I'm going to do the second shine sprite of Ricco Harbor here, and it's going to be one that you might remember quite a bit here. Well, if you've been around for a while, I did a video response long ago to Chugga Conroy when he said that, when he did this one, and he asked people to beat his time, basically, and post it as a video response in this Blooper race thingy here. And so I did, and I posted the video, and I explained everything in that video. If you want to see it, you can check my random videos playlist. But anyway, if you don't want to, I'll just re-explain it here. Basically, you've got three bloopers here. They all control differently. The pink one is the fastest and the hardest to control. It doesn't turn very well. The greenish, bluish, teal one, it's kind of hard to tell. A lot of people say it's blue, a lot of people say it's green, so I'm just going to call it teal as a balance. Well, anyway, it's the slowest one, and it's the easiest to control. In fact, it's really, really touchy, so you might want to use that one if you're a beginner. But the yellow one is, like, right in between, which is the one that I'm going to use, because this is actually way too touchy for me to use, and this is way too hard to control for a consistent run. But anyway, just jump on the blooper. Well, you actually just walk onto it, and you control it with the control stick, and that's really all there is to it. I believe you can press up to accelerate, and that's about it. You can't slow down more than just releasing the control stick. And this is the blooper race thingy here, and what you gotta do is get to the finish line in under 45 seconds to get the shine sprite. So, let's do this! Woo! And you gotta love the music in this area. Well, in fact, this game has a lot of great music in general. Usually I talk about the music a lot in the games, but I haven't been doing that lately. But music in games deserves a lot— whoa! Deserves a lot more praise than it does. Oh, I should also add, if you ever hit a wall with the blooper, you will instantly die! Yay! Okay, around this corner, jump here to get across there and do a little shortcut, and jump here again for another shortcut, and chafe that blooper's belly on the ground if you have to. Getting under 35 seconds, if I'm not mistaken, will give you a secret shine, which I'll do later. Alright, maybe it's under 40 seconds. I don't know, I'll probably put up a box or something like that later. But anyway, there's your shine! Easy! Alright, Shine 3 of Ricco Harbor is the Cage Shine Sprite. This is actually a take 2, because I just wasn't liking my commentary in the first one. And yeah, I'm just gonna redo it from the start, just to make it more entertaining. What they want you to do is go along this pathway here, but what you can do for a little shortcut is to jump on top of the smokestack of that boat over there, and then get on top of the scaffolding with a side flip. But I always like to do the normal path in walkthroughs, you know, just to give you a feel of what the designers intended you to do, as well as give you a good feel for the level itself. So I'm just gonna take the normal path until they make me take the same path again for a future shine or something like that, and then I'll take the shortcut paths, basically so I can show you around as good as I possibly can. So, yeah, just wait for these candy cane-like things. Seriously, they look like candy canes. They're red and white striped, and they're holiday-colored in general. I mean, they got red, white, and green. Come on, that just speaks of holidays all over the place. Anyway, go over here. That box right there, as I said, it's a take 2. That is a rocket nozzle box. Of course, as you see me get it in Bianco Hills, but since I already got it, you're normally not supposed to be able to get to that box right away, so I'm just going to avoid it right now, but since I unlocked it, you can get that. But what you're supposed to do is just go along this pathway until you get to the next candy cane, which is over here, and go along these fences from Super Mario World, flip the fences around, and just go like that. Eventually, you'll get to the actual rocket nozzle to unlock, which is that thing right across the scaffolding here. See that? Right off to your left there? Yeah, this is the one that unlocks all of the rocket nozzles in the area. You need that to get the shiny sprite in the area. These boards here are like trampolines. They spring you up in the air. And now what you want to do is just continue up this path like this. And there we go. Eventually, you're going to get to the very top of this, of which you're gonna need the rocket, or maybe you don't need the rocket nozzle to get up here. I could have swore you needed the rocket nozzle. Well, whatever, I unlocked it, and there's a shining sprite! Alright, Shine 4, the Secret of Ricco Tower. This is the one that I was thinking of that I needed the rocket nozzle for. Because you need to get up there, and as far as I can tell, you can't really get up there without the rocket nozzle easily. So, yeah, you get the idea. That's why I thought that I needed to get the rocket nozzle, because I was thinking of, you know, a high place, and then I kind of related the two, and stuff like that. Yeah, you get the idea. Anyway, they want you to go up there, but you need the rocket nozzle, as I said. You can get one from that landing pad over there. I don't think there's one nearby here. Just out of curiosity, I'm gonna take a quick look-see here. Yeah, there's nothing here. So here's the shortcut level to get up there a lot quicker. Just triple jump, then wall kick, and hover nozzle up here. And that's a great shortcut. As you can see, I could use that to get the Gooper, which was right over there at that fancy stone floor here. And there's the rocket nozzle that I need right over there underneath the landing pad for the helicopters. And there we go. So grab that, and go back to the lighthouse. And refill it along the way, of course, because, you know, the rocket nozzle uses a lot of water. Well, I didn't use that much water anyway. But if you need to refill it, go ahead and do so. And
whee!
Gotta love the rocket nozzle. Just propelling yourself ultra high in the air is just so much fun. And, oh, didn't make it to the scaffolding. I want to avoid that blue coin there, as I showed before, as well as those wind enemies. They're just going to be annoying to me. So, you know what, I'm just gonna keep flailing around, aren't I? So, let's plop down. Oh, come on, man. This is not that hard to do. Let's go a little bit forward. There we go. I should be a little bit more careful instead of just flailing around, and I should just be able to normal jump up to the Ricco Tower. No! My flood! He stole it once again. You know what that means? Yes, it is a special area. Which means I'm probably gonna fail a lot. Well, you got these spinning blocks of some sort. I don't know, they look kind of like kids' play blocks, like maybe Lincoln Logs or something. No, they don't even resemble Lincoln Logs, because Lincoln Logs have notches. Well, these just have, like, little points sticking out of them. Well, the idea is, obviously, to stay on these things. The easiest way to stay on them is wait for them to turn to a 45-degree angle. What I mean by that is wait for that tip to point straight up, like the corner of it, to point straight up, and then move to the side. That's definitely the easiest way to stay on them safely. Grab that one up every time you reach here, because if you lose lives on here, and you probably will lose some lives, at least... Oh, no! Oh, boy! Okay. And you're very likely to lose a few lives getting the hang of those things, so make sure you get some extra lives along the way. I bet you those nails over there have some lives for me to get there, too. Those gear-like wooden things also react the same way. But you just have to walk across them when they're at a 45-degree angle. Come on, I know one of these has an extra life, or maybe it's that one that I see just up ahead there. You can see that extra life just slightly in the distance there. I'll be over there in a second anyway. What the heck? Did you see that? my ground pound didn't pound in that nail properly, like, 2 out of the 3 times that I ground pounded. That was so weird. Wow, this is just not my day altogether. I guess there wasn't the extra life over there. Anyway, this one's a little bit trickier because you don't have the perspective you did on the other ones to see where that block is flipped. So I'll zoom out your camera and turn it to the side so you can see where it's angled. Same with that one, until you get up to this point, of course, when you have to transition over to one from one to the other. And there we go! Got another one up, so that means even if I lose a life, I will come out one life ahead each time, you know, unless I die early in this thing. And this one's a lot bigger than the rest, so you gotta really be on alert and be close to the edge like that and wait for it to flip over and get across. There we go. Oh, this went a lot smoother than I thought it would. Watch, I die right here. And then there's your shine sprite. Woo! Alright, I think the last shine that I'm gonna do in this part is episode 5, Gooper Blooper Returns. And it's exactly as it says, Gooper Blooper Returns. This time he's on the helicopter landing pad. You can easily get up there with just your hover nozzle. I'll show you a little path here that you can take. That'll make getting up there, have no trouble getting up there, I should say. And, you know, the shortcut that I did in the last shine, well, you can do that again for this one. As I said, this shortcut really, really breaks the level. Oops, I missed my triple jump there. But I could just side flip and wall jump like that, too. Okay, there we go. And now what you want to do to get up there is to triple jump or wall kick off that to get up on here, then side flip, or I guess you could normal jump up here. If you ground pound these things, you get fruit. That's for a much later mission. I won't be able to do that. It's for episode 8, and I won't be able to do that until I get something. And oh my god, I'm already up here. And why did I just jump right into his face there? I don't know. And there we go. I'm gonna try and do a little risk here and try and pull a schnoz. Oh, I didn't make it, but that's okay. I just thought I would try that for the heck of it. Sometimes you can get his schnoz pulled off without pulling off those front two tentacles, which I thought I would try for the fun of it. Anyway, as I said before, to get him to do his multi-tentacle slam attack there, and by command, just squirt him with water. And once his front two tentacles are off, you can just pull on his nose and he won't attack you. Nope, that's not it. He's once again gonna go into a second phase. Don't worry about falling off the edge or something like that here, because there's water down below. I mean, come on now. This is a very, very water-filled area. It's Ricco Harbor, for Pete's sake. So, don't panic about that whatsoever. What the heck? Come on, grab. There we go. I was gonna say, why didn't he grab the tentacle? And ow. That was so weird. It's like Mario's not working. Or I should say the physics aren't working for me today. Anyway, now I should be able to grab his schnoz one last time and kill him. Well, it doesn't necessarily kill him, but this has definitely gotta hurt. Like, see, he's alive right there, and he just plops in the water, and somehow he magically disappears. Looks like he goes, like, maybe into the sand or something like that, but as soon as he hits the sand, he disappears. He doesn't even make a puff of smoke from the sand underwater. But anyway, there's the shine, and that's all for this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part.